Okay, so today we are going to discuss about the microbiology of ice cream. So in this course, we will study about the different stages of manufacturing process. What are the different kind of microorganisms affect the overall quality of your ice cream? And what are the significance of different steps as far as the total number of contaminants or total number of microorganisms which are responsible for creating some spoilages problem as well as some kind of disease causing microorganisms may enter into the system and ultimately it creates some type of problem in the human health. So, if you talk about the history, you all know that ice cream is also one of the well-known product. And ancient manuscript, just by going through those manuscript, you can have idea that Chinese like a frozen product made by mixing fruit juices with snow. What we now call water ice. And one very important information, if you go in history of ice cream, you will get that Marco Polo visited different part of China. And when he returned back to Italy in 1295, he simply got idea about the ice cream, and he transferred that idea to different people of Europe. And ultimately, what is happening that these ice cream spread through Europe during the 17th century. So, long remaining a luxury product for the royal court. In industrial ice cream production began at the end of the 19th century when the first mechanical refrigerator was introduced in the world market. Now, something about the historical development of ice cream. China is believed to be one of the origin of ice cream. Who invented the device that produces sorbets and ice cream at around 200 BC? Thereafter, in 37 to 68 AD, it was recorded that Emperor Nero had ice brought from the Alps to create chilled delicacies mixed with fruit toppings. Thereafter, in the year, at the time of Mughal Emperor in 16th century, they were used horsemen to obtain ice from the Hindu Kush to produce fruit sorbets served on their table. Thereafter, in 1674, the first recipe of flavored ice cream was appeared, followed by various recipes, which was later began to be published in 1694. And thereafter, as all of you know, that in 18th century, ice cream had become popular and become less expensive, making it readily available to ordinary people. So in this way, ice cream was developed throughout the world. Now something about the typical ice cream formulas. What are different types of ice creams? They are dessert ice cream, milk ices, then sorbet, water ice, sorbet. And these are the different fat percentage, milk SNF percentage, sugar percentage, then water, overrun, and emulsifier stabilizer percentage. So just by going through, you can have idea that what is the percentage level of different component in different type of ice cream. Now, what are the things we are using in case of fat? We are mainly using milk, cream, butter, or sometimes you are replacing this milk fat by vegetable fat, but it is not called ice cream. As all of you know, in techno courses, you must have studied about all this. Then milk SNF, milk solids, not non-fat. That is protein, lactose, salts. Then sugar, sucrose, it is generally used as sucrose, glucose, dextrose, or syrup. Then emulsifier and stabilizer. Emulsifier and stabilizer examples are monoglyceride, locust bean gum, then guar gum, carrageenan. So these are the emulsifier as well as the stabilizer which we are using for during manufacturing process of ice cream. Then overrun, amount of air is also added. And thereafter, other ingredients like flavors, color, fruits, nuts, and chocolates pieces may also be added during processing operation. Now, we are mainly concerned with the microbiology of ice cream. You know that there are a number of different type of ingredients which we are using or which we are combining for preparation of ice cream mixes. So what are those things? Some are dairy products, gelatin we are using, sugar, flavoring material, coloring matter, eggs, as well as air. So these things are used for preparation of ice cream. Now the next is the contamination at, what is happening in that? Contamination at manufacturing level or during handling of that ice cream, whatever ice cream you have prepared. The various mix ingredients that may act as a source of organisms to the ice cream, that is, that should be, we should have idea about that what kind of items we are taking and what is the microbiological quality of those items. Ingredients added to ice cream mix before pasteurization, and they normally constitute little microbial contamination except some spores. However, microbial analysis is very important in establishing the quality of ingredients such as milk, cream, other dairy products, chocolates, coca, eggs, emulsifier, stabilizers, and other food additives. So we are using a number of different type of components for preparation of ice cream mix. So if you are taking a good quality of raw material of all these items, automatically you can prepare a very good quality of final product. That is a thumb rule for production of any dairy product. Now the microbiological quality of ingredients, that is very important. We have already discussed that there should be a very few number of microorganisms in there, or whatever prescribed limit is there, all the raw material must possess that level of microbial quality or microbial numbers. So here, the ultimate quality of the finished ice cream depends not only on the numbers, but also the type of bacteria present in the mixed ingredient. So every time we are discussing about the type of micro, different type of microbe, which are mainly responsible for creating some kind of health hazard or health type of problem, health issues. So automatically, number, not only number, we should also think about the type of microorganism. Now the contamination at manufacture and handling. The presence of microorganisms or different type of bacteria, if it is higher in number in frozen dairy product and ingredients are indication of improper sanitation and processing and handling condition. So if the number is high, automatically if it gives you idea about the improper sanitation, improper processing treatment or improper handling condition maintained during manufacturing. Now the bacterial contamination varies with raw milk use, separation process, inadequate refrigerated storage and long distance transport. So whatever ingredients you are using, a proper microbial contamination should be minimized, and you should not cross the prescribed limit fixed by different standard fixing authorities or different legislative guidance which given by the different different authorities. Usually, cream contains high bacterial count than the milk from which it is made, and such cream may be a single chief sources of bacteria in ice cream. Now, something about the overall quality, that is called microenvironment of ice cream. What is there inside ice cream? The microenvironment refers to the immediate condition that surround the ice cream. It includes the temperature, a storage container, packing material that surround the ice cream, etc. So whatever packing material or whatever instruments we are using for preparation of ice cream, that must be maintained. So you should keep a good sanitary condition and it should be properly cleaned before use. Now, during a storage, the temperature should be maintained at around minus 20 degrees centigrade without any major fluctuation. Otherwise, there may be chances of not only entering or whatever microbe present in the system that will create some kind of abnormal situation or abnormal problem in your product. If there is variation in temperature with time, it may lead to quality deterioration in the ice cream and microbial spoilages. The surface of the container in which the ice cream is stored, it also plays a major role in the quality. The surface of the container which we are using for storing purposes. So we should keep our mind to minimize, our main aim is to minimize the total bacterial load. Whatever container you are using, whatever surface of container is there, that should be properly cleaned. The content of ice cream with the container serves as a medium to of heat transfer to maintain the storage temperature. That is also very important. The container which you are using, that should, there should be a proper transfer of temperature when you are storing that product. Then high heat conducting, odorless, non-corrosive stainless steel material are mainly generally preferred for doing all these things. And if packed in packaging material prior to storage, they should not impart any color odor to the product. That is also very important. So there should not be any air pocket in the ice cream storage, as they serve as the source of spoilage during storage. So these things are very important to maintain a good quality product and maintaining microenvironmental condition of ice cream during manufacturing process. Now the microenvironment also refers the immediate conditions that surround the ice cream. Microenvironment may include the temperature, storage container. So you have already discussed about all these things. Now something about the safety aspect of ice cream. The potential enteropathogens encountered in ice cream are mainly originating from either the gradients or as environmental contaminants. Among the ingredients, raw milk or cream are the main source of Campylobacter jejuni, Salmonella dublin, Escherichia coli, Listeria monocytogenes, and Yersinia enterocolitica. As all of you know that these microorganisms have ability to transmit some kind of abnormal, they are responsible for creating some kind of abnormality in human being. So automatically the entry of these microorganisms should be restricted. Now sweeteners, especially systems, have been known to contribute Escherichia coli and Salmonella. The pathogens of importance from egg or egg products are Proteus, Salmonella, Enterococcus. Similarly, the coloring material which we are using may also be a source of Escherichia coli and Salmonella. From the environment source, the major pathogens of importance are Listeria monocytogenes, Yersinia enterocolitica, and Salmonella species. So one must have idea about these microorganisms, how they can get entry into the product mix and ultimately responsible for creating so many problems to human being. They may be found more in wet, than in dry areas of dairy plant. So automatically, we should select our area inside our dairy processing unit where which is mainly dry. Now this is manufacturing process of ice cream. You have already idea about the manufacturing processes, and you have already read about all these thing in technology courses. Raw milk, heating, skim milk powder addition, thereafter heating, cream, thereafter addition of sugar, then emulsifier, addition of emulsifier and a stabilizer, then pasteurization at 85 degrees centigrade for 5 minutes. Thereafter cooling for 50 degrees centigrade in case of if you want to add some kind of fruit juices or fruit purees, automatically you have to go for this additional step, and in that case you have to also go for homogenization processes, and thereafter aging for 24 hours, then freezing for 15 minutes, hardening at minus 24 degrees centigrade, thereafter storage of this ice cream at minus 32 degrees centigrade is generally recommended. It's a standard method generally used during manufacturing operation. Now the different things which affect the overall microbiological quality of ice cream. The first of all, raw milk. So what kind of raw milk is required? Whatever raw milk you are taking, that must be of good quality, must have a very low bacterial count. And in, when you are adding or using some kind of dairy products such as liquid milk, cream or skim milk concentrate, then it should must be added after receiving adequate heat treatment or thereafter cooling and storage. The original raw milk may have a count of less than 10,000 per ml. If produced under sanitary condition and properly cooled, or it may have a count as high as 5 into 10 to the power 6 to 1 into 10 to the power 8 colony forming per ml. So automatically you have to maintain a very hygienic condition during production, at the time of production of raw milk, and during transportation and storage of this, just to minimize the total bacterial count. The number and types of microorganisms in milk immediately after production directly reflect microbial contamination during production, collection and handling. So a use of full indicator for monitoring the sanitary condition present during the production, collection, handling raw milk is the total bacterial count or a standard plate count. So SPC values for raw milk can range from below 1000 CFU per ml. So we should maintain this label if you want to produce a very good quality ice cream. Now something about the types of microorganisms. The most commonly occurring psychotrophs in raw milk are the gram-negative rods, Pseudomonas species. They accounts for at least 50% of total bacterial population. Pseudomonas fluorescens are the predominating in that. Now in addition to that, some other species also includes Pseudomonas putida, Pseudomonas fraesei, Pseudomonas aeruginosa, Flavobacterium, Acinetobacter, Moraxella, then Acromobacter, Alkaligenes, Chromobacterium, Aromonas, Klebsiella, and coliform group comprise most of the remaining psychotropic gram-negative rods. So automatically, you have to control the condition, you have to minimize the number of these all microorganisms, otherwise it may create some kind of abnormality in your final product. The majority of these coliforms are the Arobacter species, microflora of pasteurized milk. What are the different type of microflora generally found in pasteurized milk? They are the thermoduric organisms present in raw milk supply. Thereafter, raw milk contact with contaminated handling and processing equipment. Then entry after the pasteurization process. A number of different kind of contaminating microorganisms may enter into the system after getting the processing treatment. So we should minimize or we should restrict the entry of different kind of contaminating microorganisms. Then typical total bacterial numbers in freshly pasteurized milk should be very less, and you should maintain this thing. Now, the second most important item which you are selecting or which you are using for ice cream manufacture is cream. You have already studied so many things about the cream, how you can maintain the quality of your final cream. So best ice cream is made from sweet and unneutralized cream, which has not been subjected to microbial action. Cream with off flavor, if used, will be reflected in the finished product. Now, what type of test should be done? Yeast and mold count, mesophilic bacteria count, then coliform, then lipolytic bacteria. So we should check the total number of these microorganisms in cream before using it as a raw material. Now the important spoilage organism is Pseudomonas frisei, which causes unpleasant taste and taints. The spoilage is usually the result of chemical changes producing rancid and other off flavors. So what type of problem they are creating? Pseudomonas is responsible for creating rancid taste and some other off flavors. If butter is used, it should be preferably be stored at minus 18 degrees centigrade to 20 degrees centigrade. If you are using whole milk or skim milk, that must be of high quality and it should be free from toxic producing microorganisms. So the raw milk should have SPC less than 2 lakhs per ml. Pasteurized milk SPC should be less than 30,000 per ml. In fresh cream, the three dominating microorganisms, if you are storing or keeping your cream at 50 degrees centigrade, in that case, you will get Pseudomonas, Alkaligenes, Acinetobacter, Aromonas, and Acromobacter. And if you are keeping your milk at 30 degrees centigrade, prepare your cream with the milk which you have kept at 30 degrees centigrade, then number of Corynebacterium, Bacillus, Micrococcus, Lactobacillus, and Staphylococcus will be more in that kind of cream. The next important item is butter. You have already studied a lot about butter, what kind of microbiological quality is required in butter, and if it is contaminated, and if the number of total contaminating microorganisms is high in butter, automatically it will add some number of microbe in your ice cream. So the quality must be maintained and must be ensured before selecting or before taking butter. Now, butter has been regarded as high-risk product. However, the presence of potentially pathogenic genus given an indication of the post-process contamination problem. Butter and anhydrous milk fat, sometimes people are using butter oil, are product made under careful control from cream that has been heat treated at a relatively high temperature. So therefore, a very high microbiological quality is to be expected. And spoilage is only as a result of chemical changes producing rancid and other off flavors. So the quality of butter should be of very good. Otherwise, you will have to face so many abnormal situation during the freezing, or when you will get a final product, it will create so many abnormal condition and sometimes you will have to face a spoilage problem. So taste of yeast, mold, mesophilic bacteria, coliform, and the presence of lipophilic organisms should be carried out. And however, in particular, the presence or absence of Pseudomonas frisei should be noted, as these organisms can cause unpleasant taint in butter. So this particular microorganism is very important because they are responsible for producing unpleasant taint in butter. So butter should be preferably stored at temperature below minus 20 degrees centigrade. And as for all the ingredients, careful stock control should be ensured. So for getting good quality product, you should have a very maintained condition where you are stocking your raw material. Now, another important product is dried and concentrated milk. A number of microorganisms are there which may present in dried milk or concentrated milk which you are taking or which you are using for manufacturing of ice cream. What is happening in this and what type of contamination you can get from dried and concentrated milk? Skim milk powder, as you know, that may contain a number of Bacillus cereus, though not a major health hazard, but the number should be as low as possible. Bacilli reduce methylene blue rapidly and can produce clotting in milk. And they can grow at relatively low temperature, and in extreme cases, it is responsible to cause a spoilage of ice cream mix. So automatically, the number of these microbes should be low whenever you are using sweetened condensed milk or dried milk. Now, the bacterial standard intended for ice cream manufacturing should be SPC maximum limit is 500 per ml. Then in case of dried milk, SPC should be the maximum limit of a standard plate count is 30,000 per gram or per ml, per gram sample, and coliform that is maximum 90. Then the condensed milk should be stored in manner that prevent entrance of insect, bacteria and mold. So you have to have a good control during storage. Wherever you are storing this skim milk powder or condensed milk or dry milk, which you are using for ice cream manufacturing. Then Listeria monocytogenes may survive and typical spray drying. It has been observed that Listeria monocytogenes may survive whatever temperature you are using in spray drying process. So you should check the presence or absence of Listeria monocytogenes. And it is very important, and it is also mentioned in our FASAI standard that there should not be a single Listeria monocytogenes present in our dairy product. Now the sugar, one of the most important item which you are using for sweetening processes. It contains no moisture and therefore should not contain very, less chances of different kind of microorganisms present in it. So whatever granulated sugar or dextrose you are going to use in preparation of ice cream mix, that should be almost sterile. Then total count of any sugar should not be more than 200 per gram. Now when you are using sugar syrup, They may contain osmophilic yeast and mold, which may grow on the surface if your surface is contaminated. In that case, now a standard is given for sugar, thermophilic spores not more than 125 per 10 gram to 150 per 10 gram. Then yeast, it should not be more than 10 in 10 gram of sample, mold not more than 8 colony forming unit in 10 grams. Then flat sour spores, it should also not more than 50 in number in 10 gram samples. Now, the number of microorganisms contributed to the ice cream mix by the sugar is usually insignificant. However, it was found to be necessary to heat the sugar solution separately in the form of a solution at 112.7 to 115.5 degrees centigrade. So the sugar which you are taking is not so vulnerable for our ice cream milk mix, but it should be heat treated before adding in ice cream mix. In order to meet the rigid standard which classify ice cream with a count less than 10,000 per gram as good and with a count of less than 50,000 as fair. So you can just go through the FASAI standard table in which it is mentioned. Now the granulated sugar as well as other dry sugar such as dextrose should be almost sterile, and the only organisms that may normally be present are small in numbers are from yeast, So the sugar syrup, sucrose, corn syrup, or mixture of these, or lactose and whey syrups, again may contain some yeast. So it is suggested that taste of for such yeast should be made on bulk deliveries of sugar and sugar syrups. So it is very important to maintain the total number of yeast in your sugar items. Coliforms, yeast and mold, anaerobic thermophilic, hydrogen sulfide and non-hydrogen sulfide producers, aerobic spore former, thermophiles, basophile acid producers should be tested before selecting sugar from different companies or different suppliers. Now it is important to know something about the stabilizer. As all of you know, that production of ice cream with high overrun is an interesting tool for cost saving. However, the perceived quality by the consumer has to be kept in mind. The sensory attributes such as creaminess and smoothiness, as well as resistant to shrinkages and melting, cannot be compromised, as these properties are very closely linked to the consumer preferences. So automatically, if you want to maintain that level of quality in your ice cream, automatically you have to receive or use a very good quality of a stabilizer in ice cream manufacturing process. Creaminess as well as melting resistance is related to the distribution of air cells in the product. And if air cell distribution is more uniform in the ice cream system, it will ultimately result in a creamier and slower melting ice cream. So the proper distribution of air is very important, and just to stabilize the whole system, you have to choose a particular type of emulsifier for improving or maintaining such conditions inside your ice cream. Emulsifiers like mono and diglycerides are well known for their positive influence in this respect. And the option if you are going to choose a particular type of stabilizer or emulsifier, you must consider these things in your mind and keep in your mind. Most countries allow the use of a wide range of stabilizer. The most commonly used stabilizers in ice cream are locust bean gum, then guar gum, cellulose gum, carrageenan, alginate. So these are the things you should use in ice cream. So what are the other features of a stabilizer? Whatever stabilizer you use for maintaining smooth texture and body by preventing, its main purpose is to prevent the formation of large ice crystals. Then stabilizers should not present any problem but gelatin.